दोस्तों एक और मैटर आपको प्रोवाइड करूंगा, 80W पेन पर 800 वर्ड्स की डिक्टेशन है। ऐसा मैटर शायद ही आपने पहले लिखा हो, क्योंकि मैंने आपको बताया था कि मैं एडिटोरियल्स को मिक्स करके ये मैटर प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूं। और अच्छे से इन्हें लिखिए, आपको एग्जाम में कोई दिक्कत नहीं आएगी, ये मेरा वादा है आपसे। अगर आपने ईमानदारी से इनको अच्छे से किया तभी आपको कोई दिक्कत नहीं आएगी, क्योंकि अगर आप ईमानदारी खुद से नहीं दिखाएंगे तो फिर तो प्रॉब्लम आपको आनी ही आनी है। ठीक है, तो जैसा मैं कहता हूँ ईमानदारी दिखाइए, ईमानदारी दिखाएंगे कोई दिक्कत नहीं आएगी। 80W पेन पर आपको डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूँ, अच्छे से इसे लिखिएगा, बी रेडी फॉर इट। As a report card cum blueprint for the future chief economic advisor Krishnamurthy Subramanian's economic survey 2019-20 is a mixed bag of interesting diagnoses combined with some optimistic prognostication 7 months after His maiden survey, he finds himself again having to assess the economy's health and provide signposts for the agenda ahead. And the CEA, who is July, projected real GDP growth rebounding to 7% this fiscal. Acknowledges that 2019 was a difficult year for the global economy, including for trade and demand, and by extension, a challenging period for the Indian economy as well. The survey concedes that a sharp decline in fixed investment induced by a sluggish growth of real consumption has weighed down growth, which the National Statistical Office now estimates at 5% for the 12 months ending in March. The stress in the non-bank financial industry and decline in credit growth that the IMF flagged in January when It cut its India growth estimate for the current fiscal to 4.8% from October's 6.1% find reflection in the survey. Interestingly, a chapter devoted to financial fragility in the NBFC sector recommends a dynamic health index that policymakers can use as an early warning system to avert incipient liquidity crisis in this key credit providing sector. Listing downside risks to next fiscal's outlook including continuing global trade uncertainties, escalation in West Asian geopolitical tensions, slow pace of insolvency resolution and the possibility of further fiscal pressure crowding out private investment, the CEA, however, takes a leap of faith in forecasting growth rebounding to a 6 to 6.5% range. He reiterates an expectation from his previous survey, given the government's strong mandate, it ought to expedite reforms. The survey also makes a political statement on budget eve. Expect more policy incentives for wealth creation, featuring as a central theme of the first volume. The survey asserts that India's wanted historical economic dominance was reliant on the invisible hand of the market for wealth creation, supported by ethical practices that engendered trust. To ensure smoother functioning of markets as creators of wealth, the survey makes several policy prescriptions. contending that government interventions hurt more than they help, it recommends scrapping the Essential Commodities Act enacted in 1955 when famines and shortages were the concern. Similarly, it asserts that the Drug Prices Control Order of 2013 has failed to achieve its aim of making drugs affordable and needs to go. And the CEA wants a complete review of the policy on food grains, which he argues has made the government the largest holder, thereby distorting these markets. All are suggestions that traders and market players, a key electoral constituency, will cheer, but may be fraught with risks. The European Union Parliament's discussion recently on India's Citizenship Amendment Act or CAA is more proof of concern, particularly in the West, over the possible repercussions of the law and the protests across India. Parliamentarians in the UK and US congressmen, including Democratic presidential contenders, have asked India to reconsider the law and to engage with the protesters. The EU parliamentarians went a step further, putting out 6 different and extremely critical resolutions, including one that spoke of the possible risk by the CAA and the proposed National Register of Citizens of creating the largest statelessness crisis in the world. A 6th less critical resolution, but which worried about the brutal crackdown on protesters, was dropped. After India's intense diplomatic outreach, the parliamentarians agreed to put off voting on the resolution until after External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar and Prime Minister Modi visit Brussels, according to the EU member requesting the postponement, India will address Europe's concerns. The government has called this a diplomatic victory, blaming Pakistan and also a British MEP with Pakistan-occupied Kashmir origins for strenuous efforts to attack India in the EU Parliament. The hope is that with the UK scheduled to leave the EU on January 31, interest in the anti-CAA resolutions will wane. Finally, the government has held that the CAA is India's internal law. While the government is right about India's sovereign right, it would be deluding itself if it thinks any of these explanations are passing muster with the EU parliamentarians. The government diluted its own case against foreign interference when it facilitated a visit by EU MEPs to Srinagar last year, when even Indian MPs were not allowed to visit. By engaging the EU MEPs to avoid a vote in the EU Parliament this week and offering to explain the reasons behind CAA, the government is slipping up further. New Delhi must also consider the impact of its रिपीटेड रेफरेंस टू पाकिस्तान एज द सोल मूवर ऑफ एनी मोशन अगेंस्ट इट एट वर्ल्ड लेजिस्लेचर्स एंड फोरा इट सीज ए स्ट्रेच दैट पाकिस्तान विच इज इट्सेल्फ ऑन इंटरनेशनल नोटिस फॉर टेररिज्म एंड अटैक्स ऑन माइनॉरिटीज कैन ब्रिंग सच वेट टू बियर। दोस्तों इसी के साथ ही डिक्टेशन फिनिश होती है। बहुत ही ज़बरदस्त डिक्टेशन है, मतलब कि मुझे नहीं लगता कि इससे टफ कुछ मैटर आपके पास आ सकता है, क्योंकि इसमें काफ़ी वर्ड्स ऐसे हैं जो आपको बहुत दिक्कत दे सकते हैं। मेरे हिसाब से मेरी आपसे यही एक गुजारिश रहेगी कि आप वीडियो के नीचे कमेंट करके मुझे ज़रूर बताइएगा कि आपने इसको कैसे लिखा, कितनी मिस्टेक्स आपकी आई, कितना आपका छूटा इसमें, क्योंकि 80 की स्पीड है, फ्लक्चुएशंस बहुत कम है, क्योंकि मैटर बहुत टफ है। मेरे हिसाब से टफ इसलिए है क्योंकि नए वर्ड्स आपको इसमें देखने को मिले हैं, कुछ ऐसे वर्ड्स कंटिन्यूसली आए हैं जिसकी जब बहुत वर्ड्स कुछ ऐसे टफ वर्ड्स या फिर नए वर्ड्स एक ही लाइन में ज़्यादा आते रहते हैं, तो उस वजह से आपको मैटर ऑटोमेटिकली टफ लगता है। सो मेरा मानना यह है कि अगर ये मैटर आपने बहुत अच्छे से किया है, आपको एग्ज़ाम में कोई दिक्कत नहीं आएगी। ठीक है, तो आपसे मुलाकात करूँगा अब मैं अगली क्लास में एक नए मैटर के साथ। तब तक के लिए बाय बाय, टेक केयर।